गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विद प्रैक्टिस सेट 39। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट पार्टनरशिप एंड ऑल्सो हैड गिवन यू नोट्स रिलेटेड टू दैट। सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द कंसेप्ट, द सॉल्व्ड एग्जाम्पल एंड ऑल्सो यू हैव रिटन द नोट्स इन योर CW। सो वॉट यू आर गोइंग टू डू, आफ्टर राइटिंग द नोट्स इन योर CW, now you are going to write practice set 39 after it, and you are going to write this first question in your CW. And listen students, you have to complete your books as the videos are sent to you all. Keep your books completed, okay? So the first question we are going to start with, that is, Suresh and Ramesh together invested 1,44,000 rupees in the ratio 4:5. Yes, so see children, both of them have invested how much rupees? 1,44,000 rupees. And in which ratio, what is the ratio they have invested? The ratio they invested is 4:5. So here Suresh is the first person, so the ratio of, or the part of Suresh will be 4 and that of Ramesh will be 5. So both of them's ratio is 4:5. And what did they buy? See further, and bought a plot of land. So plot of land was bought for how much rupees? 1,44,000 rupees. See further, after some years they sold it at a profit of 20%. So after some year, the same plot they had sold, and they sold the same plot after making the profit of 20%. Okay. Now, what is the profit each one of them got? What we have to find? We have to find the profit made by each one of them. So did you understand the question? Once again, see, we know the amount they spent, the ratio, we also know the profit of made by them, and now we have to find profit each of them got. Okay, so whatever profit students they have got, do we know that amount of profit? No. So first we are going to find the amount of profit whatever they have got. We know the profit in percentage, we don't know the specific amount. So first we will find the amount of profit, and then we will find their ratio and how much profit each one of them have got. Okay, so now let's solve the sum. So now we will write the first thing, that is the total investment. So total invested is equals to rupees 1,44,000. And now we have to find the profit earned. So profit earned is 20%. Yes, they have given in percent. Now we are going to find it in rupees. So 20% of 1,44,000 means here he has earned 20% profit on 1,44,000 rupees. So 20/100 multiplied by 1,44,000, zeros will get cancelled. What remains? 2 multiplied by 14,400. If you will multiply, you will get 28,800 rupees. So here this is the profit earned by both of them. So we can write total profit earned. Okay, so the total profit earned by Suresh and Ramesh is we have got, and they are getting this profit in the ratio 4:5. So we will assume X and we will write here, let the profit of Suresh be 4x. Okay, so we, and that of Ramesh be 5x. So here we have written the assume sentence. Both of this profit. Now here I have taken 4x and 5x because they have earned the profit, to total profit by both of them, and it is their ratio. Yeah, 4x and 5x, if we will write in ratio, x gets cancelled, that is nothing but 4:5. Yes, so total
profit earned by both of them is equals to 28,800 rupees. So we will write total profit earned is equals to rupees 28,800. And as both of them have earned the profit, we are going to write 4x plus 5x is equals to 28,800. 4x plus 5x, 9x is equals to 28,800. So 9 with x we have 9. Yes, so that 9 we will take other side, it will get divided. Yes, so therefore x is equals to 28,800 upon 9. After carrying out division, 9 ones are 9, 3s are 27, 9 twos are 18 and 0 and 0. So we get x is equals to 3,200. So here we have got the value of x. Now we are going to find what is the profit each one of them have got. So profit of Suresh is 4x and profit of Ramesh is 5x. Yeah. So for x value we all know. So 4 into 3,200 will give us 4 into 32 will give us 128 and 2 zeros. So 12,800. Same way, 5 into 3,200, if we will multiply, we will get the answer rupees 16,000. So here we have got both of this profit. So we can write Suresh got profit of rupees 12,800 and Ramesh got a profit of rupees 16,000. So here we have got the solution of the first question. I hope you have understood it. Now neatly you are going to write this solution with the question in your CW. I have written side by side. You can solve one below the other and complete the solution of question number 1. Let us now move on to the sum number 2. Virat and Samrat together invested 50,000 and 1,20,000 rupees to start a business. So here they have given us 2 persons. They are Virat and Samrat. So they have started a business by investing certain amount. So the amount invested by Virat is 50,000 and by Samrat is 1,20,000 rupees. So by looking at the amount, we can understand that Samrat has invested more amount compared to Virat. Yes, and by investing this, they have started a business. So now let's move further. They suffered a loss of 20%. So here, after starting a business, they have suffered a loss. And they have suffered a loss of how much? Yes, of 20%. So they have given the loss in percentage, not in amount. Yes. So we have to find that exact amount of loss, isn't it? Next, see, how much loss did each of them incur? So what we have to find out? Loss each of them incur. Means how much loss did Virat suffer and how much loss did Samrat got? Yeah, this we have to find out. So did you understand the question? Now let's move on to the solution. So now we have to find out how much loss each one of them incurred. Yes, so for that we should know the ratio of their investment. Yes, so first we will find their ratio. So we are going to write here Virat upon Samrat is equals to, so Virat's amount is 50,000. Yeah, so we'll write 50,000 upon Samrat's is 1,20,000. After this we are going to cancel the zeros, so total 4 zeros get cancelled. So what remains? 5 upon 12, which is nothing but 5 is to 12. So this is the ratio. Virat's ratio is 5 and Samrat's ratio is 12. Now we are going to find the loss they incurred on total amount or total investment. So we don't know total investment, we know separate. So first we are going to find out their total investment. Yeah, so total investment is equals to 50,000 of Samrat Virat plus 1,20,000 of Samrat will give us 1,70,000. So here this is the total investment, and loss incurred on that is 20%. So loss is equals to 20% of 1,70,000. That is, so students, loss is always considered or calculated on total amount, okay? So 20%, how it is written? 20 upon 100 into 1,70,000. So 0 to 0 gets cancelled. What remains? 2 into 17,000. That is equals to rupees 34,000. So here we have got the total loss incurred. Yes, means total loss we know on the total investment. Now we have to find loss incurred by each one of them. Yes, so how much Virat has suffered, that ratio we know, Virat and Samrat, 5 to 12. So we will write here, let the loss of Virat be 5x and loss of Samrat be 12x. Yes, we know 5 and 12 x will go, then what remains? 5 is to 12, yes or no? So now, see further, now total loss is equals to rupees 34,000. Therefore, both of them's loss, na? Both of them have incurred the loss. So we are going to write addition of that, their ratio, which will be equal to the loss. So 5x plus 12x is equals to 34,000. 5x plus 12x, 17x is equals to 34,000. X is equals to 34,000 upon, why? With x what is there? 17, which is multiplied. At other side it will go and get divided. So divided by 17. 17 ones are 17, twos are 34. And 3 zeros you will add. Therefore x is equals to 2000. So did we get x value? Yes. So now we know Virat's ratio and Samrat's ratio, that is 5x and 12x. Yeah. So we are going to substitute value of x. Virat's loss is equals to 5x and Samrat's is 12x. So 5x and 12x we have written. And x value we know. So 5 into 2000 will give 10,000. 12 into 2000 will give us 24,000. So we have got each one of them's loss. Virat's loss is 10,000 and Samrat's is 24,000. Why? Samrat's loss is more because ratio of Samrat is more compared to Virat. You can see Samrat's is 12 and Virat's is 5. So loss incurred by Samrat is more. Now just add 10,000 plus 24,000. Are you getting 34,000? So is it total loss? Yes or no? So both of them's addition of loss gives us total loss. So thus we have got the answer to our question. Each one of their loss. So now we are going to write last statement. Virat's loss is rupees 10,000 and Samrat's loss is rupees 24,000. So here we have got the solution for our second question. I hope you have understood it. Listen to the video carefully and write down the sum in neatly in your CW. Write one below the other the steps. Yes, understand and write the steps and do practice it. After solving in CW, you have to practice 3 to 4 times in your rough book so that you can solve the sums without looking, okay, or with understanding. So practice the sums thoroughly.